On the 19th of January 2025, CapCut was banned alongside TikTok in the US, and a lot of you guys in the US are starting to freak out and wonder what you should do. Should you migrate to another editor? Will CapCut ever be back? Well, as a 20 plus year video editor, I wanted to share my thoughts on what I think will happen and what you should do if you're an existing CapCut user. Firstly, I want to make it clear that this ban applies to the US only and no other countries, so if you're elsewhere, like me here in Australia, you don't need to worry. But if you are in the US, you've probably already noticed that TikTok has been reinstated after an extremely brief ban, which can only mean good news for CapCut since both companies are owned by the parent company ByteDance. My prediction is it's only a matter of time before CapCut is reinstated just like TikTok was. This hasn't happened at the time of making this video, but there's a very good chance that it will get reinstated in the next couple of days. So before you make any big changes in your workflow, I'd recommend just waiting it out and see if it gets reinstated. If it doesn't for whatever reason, here are a few alternatives about what you should do next. Firstly, CapCut did post on their Instagram saying that if you want to contact them for customer support, they provided their email there. And given that they've got a very poor history of customer service, don't hold your breath on that one. But if you really want to get a refund, I guess you could try emailing them. Another solution many users have found successful is using a VPN. So changing your internet location to another country that doesn't have CapCut banned. This may just be the temporary solution many of you need to keep editing your projects in the days it takes for CapCut to get reinstated. If you are thinking about changing platforms because this is the final straw with CapCut, you've had enough and you want to move on, there are a few good alternatives. Firstly, I'd say avoid using Premiere Pro. As a 10-year Premiere Pro user, I can say that it's very outdated in 2025. They charge too much and don't offer enough modern templates and features to make the subscription worthwhile. A much better option would be the free editor DaVinci Resolve, which you can download and start editing with right away. Just keep in mind though that this isn't a more advanced editor and will take more time to learn and master, and the overall workflow is a lot more complex than what you would be used to with CapCut. I do have a beginner's guide tutorial that you can find on my channel if you want to learn that. If you're an Apple user, I'd say Final Cut Pro is a good alternative since it is beginner friendly and it's got lots of templates, very fast, and it's not going to get banned ever. And there are also more beginner level alternatives such as Filmora by Wondershare, Veed, and a couple of others, but from my experience, they haven't been as good as CapCut, so it really would be worth waiting to see if CapCut gets reinstated, which it very likely will, so you can have all the benefits that CapCut brings, which is the fast workflow, the vast library of templates, the extremely user-friendly interface. And these three things alone are the three things that move me from Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve to CapCut. So even though it's clearly a platform built on shaky foundations, it is a good one and worth sticking around for. If you do have to or want to change to another editor though, I'd also say that it's not going to be that difficult to learn a new software since many video editors are laid out the exact same way and you just need to learn where all the tools are that you're familiar with in the new editor. So don't feel like switching editors is going to be the end of the world and take you years and years to learn. My final thoughts that I want to share is that if you are a CapCut and TikTok user and you rely heavily on the TikTok platform or any one platform to post the majority of your content and build your business around, each one of these platforms is on its own foundation. And if that foundation gets knocked out from underneath it and your business is built on it, it could ruin you in a single day if that gets torn down, which is why it's so important to diversify your platforms. So no matter which social media platforms you post on, I'd recommend diversifying to at least one more. I've found over the years that the most reliable one has been YouTube. It's been around for 20 years now. Yes, it's going to hit 20 years this year. And I've built my entire business and content strategy around it and had great success, which is why I think it's a great choice for anyone that might be reliant on platforms like TikTok or even Instagram, and you want to add more stability to your overall content strategy. So if you haven't started a channel yet and want to, check out this video here where I'll guide you through all the essential steps and settings for setting up a YouTube channel in 2025 with success. Happy editing, and I'll keep you posted on any further developments.